There is magic everywhere. Feels like Christmas in the air. All the village comes alive. Christmas Day is coming soon. Hear the people laugh and sing. Soon the bells will start to ring. All the village comes alive. Christmas Day is coming soon. See the people all dressed up in winter coats and boots and hats. Soon the day will come to light the tree. We'll turn the switch on just like that. Come and listen to me well. Hear the story I will tell. As all the village comes alive, Christmas Day is coming soon. See the people all dressed up in winter coats and boots and hats. Soon the day will come to light the tree. We'll turn the switch on just like that. Come and listen to me well. Hear the story I will tell. As all the village comes alive, Christmas Day is coming soon. Christmas Day is coming soon. Christmas Day is coming soon.
In a certain town, on a certain 1st of December morning, everyone was suddenly awakened from Christmas dreams by the joyful ringing of bells in every tower and steeple. When the townspeople looked out of their windows, they saw a white carpet of snow all over the ground. Every street lamp wore a white robe, and every picket on every fence wore a funny little snow cap. And rolling down the snowy street, behind two hard-working men who were clearing a path with their shovels, was a long convertible being driven by His Honor the Mayor. There was no doubt about it. It was time for the birth of the Littlest Snowman.
The village, come and follow me. Something's gonna happen that you really ought to see. This is the moment that we've been waiting for. Follow me all the way to the house of the boy next door. He's the one who knows how to take the snow and make a little snowman that will make our faces glow. So bring your grandma and grandpa, bring the neighbors too, bring the dogs and bring the cats and everyone with you. This is the moment that we've been waiting for. Follow me all the way to the house of the boy next door.
The people dashed out of their houses, following the mayor's car to a house which stood on Winter Avenue. There in a yard, they saw a small boy, the only one in town who knew how to make the littlest snowman. He was just patting the last bit of snow into place. Around him were many helpers. Grandfather Squirrel held the littlest snowman's old brown hat. Reuben Rabbit had the red handle of a broken kitchen spoon, which would soon be the littlest snowman's mouth. Mr. and Mrs. English Sparrow carried two pieces of coal for the eyes. And Marmaduke Mouse had a blue marble, which would be the nose. Most important of all was a candy heart on which was lettered, I Love You Truly, held by the little golden-haired girl from next door.
I love you truly. Love makes me alive. Even when the temperature climbs, love is how I survive. I would do most anything to prove my love for you, for I love you truly. Yes, I truly do.
As soon as the littlest snowman's heart was pressed gently into place beneath the second bottle top button of his vest, the mayor made his speech of welcome.
Welcome, everybody. This is a wonderful day. Dance a dance and sing a song as we go upon our way. All the way down to the park. Now won't you come with me and bring the littlest snowman to light the Christmas tree.
Then the crowd paraded to the park in the center of the town. There, the biggest Christmas tree to be found in the fir forest of the far north was decorated with thousands of ornaments and glittering tinsel. The littlest snowman pressed a switch, and the biggest Christmas tree was instantly lighted by many colored lights. Then the weatherman stepped forward. He was as long and as thin as the glass on a thermometer, and on his tall silk hat was a weather vane. At the end of a watch chain across his vest was a turnip-sized barometer. "I predict," he said, "that it will start to snow again on Christmas Eve, and that we will have an old-fashioned white Christmas this year." Everyone agreed that this was the best forecast the weatherman had ever made. Some evenings later, when the stars were twinkling brightly, the littlest snowman received a special delivery letter by helicopter pigeon inviting him to attend the annual snowman's snowball at Town Park. The famous snowball was already well underway when the littlest snowman arrived. He lost no time in joining the snow ladies and snow gentlemen who were waltzing gracefully to the sleigh bell music. Then, when he'd had enough of dancing, he helped himself to some ice water from the punch bowl on the refreshment table, and also to some appetizing colored icicles. Suddenly, over the music and the voices of the dancers, a scream was heard from one of the snow girls. Look at the snake! All the snow people turned and stared at the large thermometer which hung on a tree. Snake, in snow people language, meant the long red line that went up and down on the thermometer. The snake is crawling up and up! And it was. The snake was already wiggling well above the freezing mark. I'm melting! Wailed a fat snow lady. I'm defrosting, cried a snowman. Hurry, someone shouted. Let's go back to our yards and pull the snow blankets over our heads. With each fat little foot leaving a puddle of water behind him, the littlest snowman slushed homeward sadly. For the next few weeks, the red snake in the thermometer never crawled down below the freezing mark, and the littlest snowman became thinner and thinner. At last, the Red Cross was called in. They built a hospital of ice blocks in the littlest snowman's yard, and day and night he was tended by doctors and nurses. On the day before Christmas, the littlest snowman had grown terribly thin. However, just when he thought he would melt completely, a howling wind came into town from the North Pole. The red snake in the thermometer dropped with a hiss. Now the littlest snowman went forth to wish his fellow snow people a happy holiday. He wobbled up and down the streets on his thin little snow feet. But nowhere could he find a single snow person. They had all melted. The only person he could find was Mr. Weatherman, who was crying great tears.
No, no, no. I told them there'd be snow. People, please give me a little break, 'cause weathermen can make mistakes. No, no, no. Oh, please, please, please. I'm begging you on my knees. Please don't be too cruel on me. Don't you understand and don't you see? Weathermen make mistakes like me. Please, please, please.
It isn't going to snow, sobbed the weatherman. Not a single flake. Oh, people will never forgive me, especially the children. That's not so, said the littlest snowman. Tomorrow is Christmas, and it is always a kind and generous, loving time. Besides, I have an idea for making it snow, so come along with me. They walked across the park to an ice cream and ices factory. There they bought every last gallon of flavored ices in sight and had it delivered to the foot of the biggest Christmas tree. Now, said the littlest snowman to the weatherman, just watch me. First, he ate a gallon of strawberry ice, then a gallon of pistachio ice, then the orange, lemon, lime, and chocolate flavors, too. With every gallon he ate, the littlest snowman grew fatter and fatter and fatter. At last, he had had enough and climbed to the very top of the big Christmas tree, looking as fat and colorful as a cloud at sunset. Up there, high above the town, the north wind was so strong that the biggest Christmas tree bent and swayed. Come down, shouted the weatherman. You must climb down or you'll be blown to pieces. Of course I will, cried the littlest snowman. And just think of the beautiful snow all the children will have for Christmas. Even as he spoke, the fierce north wind began to pluck the littlest snowman as though he were a Christmas goose or turkey. Flakes of every flavor and color flew all over, giving the town the most beautiful Christmas Eve it had ever seen. But on Christmas Day, there was no littlest snowman at all.
Such a thing could never, never be. Such a thing so repulsive to me. No little snowman in this town. Imagine that. We got lots of snow underground. No little snowman in town. Such a thing so repulsive to me. Imagine that. Well, the weatherman was right after all. The weatherman made a very good call. But there's no snowman here at all. Imagine that.
Oh, but the townspeople could not have that. They hunted through the drifts, gathering every white flake, and brought them back to the little boy on Winter Avenue. He went to work, and in no time at all, there was the littlest snowman again, as good as new. In fact, he was better than new, because the little boy had added 4 gallons of vanilla ice to fatten him up. And when the candy heart was discovered to still be on the top of the biggest Christmas tree, the townspeople lifted the littlest snowman up through the branches and put his heart back right in place. All Christmas Day and all Christmas week, the littlest snowman sat there with a jolly smile on his happy face. His candy heart beat, "I love you truly," so loudly that it could be heard in every corner of the town.
Oh, I love you truly. Love makes me alive. Even when the temperature climbs, love is how I survive. I would do most anything to show my love for you. For I love you truly, yes, I truly do. Oh, I love you truly, that you need to know. I can find 1,000 ways to let this loving show. I would give you anything that I had to give. For when we love each other, that is how we truly live.
And after all, as everyone said, isn't I love you truly just another way of saying Merry Christmas?